हेलो एवरीवन, आई वेलकम यू ऑल टू दिस न्यू लेक्चर ऑन मेथड स्टडी। लास्ट लेक्चर वी कवर्ड द इंट्रोडक्शन टू द मेथड स्टडी। वी कवर्ड ऑल द स्टेप्स इन्वॉल्व्ड इन मेथड स्टडी। इन दो स्टेप्स देयर इज सेकंड स्टेप, इट इज रिकॉर्डिंग। सो टुडे वी आर कवरिंग द रिकॉर्डिंग टेक्निक्स यूज फॉर मेथड स्टडी। एंड वन थिंग शुड बी रिमेंबर दैट आवर मेथड स्टडी entire method study success is depends on this recording step. If our recordings are proper, then only our method study will be succeeded. Otherwise, it will be failed. So this is crucial step, and this is after selecting the job. The next step is to record, and these recordings should be done accurately. And those should be understandable to all the analysts which are going to study this method. So for recording, we are using charts and diagrams. So charts are most extensively used techniques to record the events for method study, and these are used to show sequence movements of man and material. Now next question may be arise: which information we are going to use in chart? So information required in chart are shown here. First is name of the product, material with code if any. At the topmost part of chart, we are going to specify the name of product and which operation is to be done, and material ka name. All the specifications are mentioned in top position of chart. Then second is process under review with starting and end point. So this is also important point to be noted. Third is chart reference number and number of sheets if any. And fourth is name of work study, analyst and approver of the same. Fifth is date of study, and sixth summary of distance, time and time, etc. So all these details, if we see any kind of form which is required, for example, if we go to bank for opening new account, then there is a account opening form. In that form, everything is mentioned: the reference number and approver and who is the applicant. Similarly, in the chart also, we are mentioning all the required data, like for which job we are going to use this chart technique, or which part number what should be part number, and who is the analyst, and who is the authority, and who will approve this chart data. So everything is mentioned in chart. So these are some symbols used in construction of chart. The first symbol is circle, and it is used to show operation. Second is half circle, and it is used to show delay in the process. Third is square box, it is used to inspection. Next is inverted triangle, it is used for storage. This storage doesn't mean memory storage, but it is storage means in store. If we are taking material from storeroom, then this symbol may be shown. And last is arrow directed towards right hand side, it is used to transportation. And first symbol is circle, which is used for operation. It indicates the main step in the process, method or procedure. Usually the part, material or product concerned is modified or changed during the operator, for example turning, drilling, milling, etc. If any kind of operation which should be shown in chart, then we will use this kind of symbol, it is circle. Next is inspection. For inspection, we are using square box. An inspection occurs when an object is examined and compared with standard for quality and quantity, for example quantity of incoming material and checking the dimension. After producing every product, we have to do inspection. So inspection ka there is step, and it is shown by square box. Next symbol is arrow directed towards right. It is used for transportation. It indicates the movement of worker, material or equipment from one place to another place. For example, movement of materials from one workstation to another. Next is half circle. It is used to show delay or temporary storage. It indicates a delay in the sequence of events. For example, worker is waiting between consecutive and operations waiting for instructions from the supervisor. So in any kind of industry, if for obtaining command from our higher authority, there may be waiting time, and this can be shown by this half circle. Next symbol is inverted triangle, which is used for storage or permanent storage. It indicates a control storage in which material is received into or issued from a store. If any material we are taking from store, then for that step we are showing this inverted triangle. Example, material kept in stores to be distributed to various work centers. For that we can use this symbol. Sometimes in industry, two or three activities are going to happen simultaneously. So these are combined activities. A combined activity occurs when two activities occur simultaneously. In such situation, the symbol for two activities are combined. For example, the circle within the symbol represents the inspection with some process. So there are two symbols actually. This circle is inscribed in square box. That means operation is also going on, and simultaneously we are doing inspection also. Now, first chart is outline process chart, or it is also called operation process chart. Now this chart is used to give bird's eye view. Suppose there is one person who is new for any industry, and he wants to know what is the overall procedure of any kind of industry. If that particular industry is producing valves, or we can say nut and bolts, then what is the sequence of operation, and what are the location of each and every machineries, and how the procedure occurs, what will be the flow of materials starting from the stores or raw material, how material will proceed, and what will be the final activity. That new person wants to know general information. He doesn't want to know each and everything. For example, who is doing cleaning activity, or who is doing inspection, but he just want to know what are the overall activities. We can say bird's eye view. So this kind of information we can show by using outline process chart. And this is very important chart. It is only giving overall activities. Remember that thing. We are not covering each and every activity. We are just looking major processes occurring in industry. So this chart will start from introduction of raw materials, and this will end with final produced goods. So here is an example of outline process chart. As we already discussed, our chart is starting with part number. Part number is given R.35. Part name is also given. It is riveted plate assembly, and location is given assembly shop. Method is mentioned here, and this charted by A.K. Ramaya. He is an analyst, and approved by L.M. Krishna. He is an officer. So there are three vertical lines shown here. This is an outline process chart. So just look the last line, or we can say rightmost line. This is the main line of our outline process chart, and we are just overviewing the industry. We are not going to all the details activities which are carrying out in industry. So this is starting from first step. First step is cut 250 mm long. Before that, there is an introduction of raw material. This is shown by this arrow mark. Arrow before number one, there is an introduction. Cold work steel strip, and dimensions are also mentioned here. 30 mm wide and 4 mm thick. Material is introduced. After that, first step, as this is an operation, so it is shown as a circular and numbered as 1, as it is first operation, cutting the strips in 250 mm long. Then again there is a second operation. It is drilling operation of, we are drilling two holes of each 3 mm diameter. Third is countersunk operation, so it is numbered as a 3. Again there is a circle. After doing all three activities, there is an first inspection, so it is numbered as 1 within the square box. Square box is used for inspection, so it is inspected for burr. After doing this, there is an introduction of sub part, sub assembly we can say. So this is part, plate number 2, plate number 2 be introduced at this first inspection. After this first inspection, there must be introduction of plate number 2 and second line. After rightmost line, rightmost vertical line, there is another middle line which is used for plate number 2. It is cold work steel strip, 30 mm wide again and 4 mm thick. But these are subsidiary operations which are shown fourth here, numbered as a fourth. This is first operation for plate 2, but overall it is fourth operation, so it is numbered as 4. Cutting the 350 mm long. Then again fifth operation, drilling two holes of each diameter 3 mm and it is inspected for burr. Then it will be introduced here and again come back to the main line. After introduction of this second plate, there is a operation locating the plate 1 top of 2. Then our next operation is introduction of rivets. So rivets are coming from another workstation. So two rivets are coming, each of diameter 3 mm and 10 mm long. So it is again leftmost line we can see there is introduction of rivets. These are coming here after fifth step. In main line we can say sixth operation is introduction of rivets. Then seventh operation is inserting the rivets, so it is numbered as 7 within the circle. And last operation, forming the rivets, it is eighth operation, so numbered as 8 within circle. And last is again inspect, so this inspection is last step. Likewise, we can draw outline process chart for our daily activities also. If for example, if we are buying some milk from outside, then we can divide all these major activity within small activities, and we can draw this outline process chart. For example, buying the milk, it will be subdivided as going to the shop, then giving the money to him, again receiving the remaining changes, receiving the goods and coming back to our home. These operations we can show by using outline process chart. We can try this example. So importance of operation process chart or outline process chart, we can see it is helpful to visualize the complete sequence of operations and inspection in the process. Know where the operation selected or detailed study fits into entire process. Understand the graphic representation of the points at which materials are introduced into the process and what operations and inspections are carried out on them as shown. So this is very important. Now next is for drawing or constructing chart, there we must follow some steps. steps are given here. It start with drawing an arrow to show the entry of the man materials, writing above the description of the component and below the line the description of the conditions. As each operation inspection takes place, the symbol is entered and numbered in the sequence with brief description on the right hand side and the time required for the operation on the left hand side. During assembly process, the major process is charted towards the right hand side of the chart and the subsidiary process on its left hand side. These are joined to each other and to the main trunk at the place of entry of the material or sub-assembly. In last, calculate and write down the total hours required. So by using this chart, we can also write the time required for each and every activity. So complete information can be provided by using this chart. One example we are going to see in next slide. Now this is an example of outline process chart and which is shown for manufacturing of electrical motor. As we already discussed, our processes start with rightmost line and it is also with introduction of material or raw material, we can say, and all three lines which are the left to the first line. Remember that our first line is rightmost line and all three lines are subsidiary operations. Subsidiary lines, which these are not main parts of our assembly, but the body is main part and stator, rotor and covers are not main part. So our activity start with operation number one. Now if we see the line, the leftmost line, right side of leftmost line is given operation name and left side of it there is a time given. So we will see one by one operation. Now first it is shown as shown by arrow, introduction of body parts. Then first operation, turning operation, turning the base. So it is operation number one, in circle numbered as a one. It requires 2 minutes. The time is also shown left side of this circle. So next operation is again, there is not inspection, there is operation. So it is shown in circular portion. It is turning, turning the bore. It requires 2.5 minutes. Third is also an operation. So it is represented in circle numbered as 3. Turning the ends, it requires 3 minutes. After doing all three operation, the next step is to inspection, to inspect. It requires 1.5 minutes. So after inspection, there is again drilling operation. So it is numbered as 4 within the circle. It requires 2.5 minutes. Then it will go for again second inspection after drilling. It is second inspection. So square box numbered as a 2. It requires 2 minutes. After that, next we have to fit the stator in this assembly. So first subsidiary operation, first left operation of main operation, first left line, we can say this is an introduction of stator motors. If we see from beginning, raw material for stator is coming inside this line and first operation is winding. So it requires 25 minutes. This is the most time consuming operation. So we can say body ka operation and stator ka operation, these are running simultaneously. So these are subsidiary, these subsidiary operations shown as a parallel lines as they are going simultaneously. After winding, again there is we can say two types of winding. So two windings are shown. First numbered as 5, second sixth number is also winding. It requires 3 minutes. Then after winding, we will go for inspection. This is third inspection. So squared box numbered as a 3. It requires 1 minute. After inspection, next operation is varnishing. It is seventh operation. It requires 3 minutes. And again, after varnish, we will inspect the stator. It requires 2 minutes. Then it will be introduced to the main body. Then next operation is numbered 8. It requires 8 minutes. It is assembly of stator to the body. After this assembly, again, two main parts for motors are required, which are shown in these two operations, two lines, leftmost line and second last left line. It is second last is rotor ka line and leftmost is covers ka line. So we will see one by one. Rotor ka introduction is shown. After that, ninth operation will be die casting. It requires 8 minutes. Then again, we will inspect for die casting. It requires 8 minutes. And it is fifth overall inspection. This is first inspection for rotor, but remember that overall it is fifth inspection. And we will starting from rightmost side. So it is fifth. Then assemble fan for the rotor. It is 10th operation. It requires 8 minutes. Then we will check it for, we will do balancing as we studied vibration. So balancing is also an important step. It is 9th operation. It requires 8 minutes. After all this operation, we will again inspect the rotor. It is 6th inspection overall if we say. Then it requires 2 minutes. Then it will be introduced to the assembly. Similarly, simultaneously we are doing for covers. Covers ka first step is turning. It requires 4 minutes. Then again there is turning. It requires 4 minutes. Then we will inspect it. It is 7th inspection. It requires 1 minute. Then drilling operation. It is 12th operation. It requires 5 minutes. After drilling, we will again inspect. It is 8th inspection. It requires 2 minutes. Then it will be introduced to the main assembly line. After after introduction of rotor and covers, then for assembly, it requires 15 minutes. And this is 15th operation. And last step is to inspect. It is 9th inspection, so numbered as a 9. So after studying this, I think everyone can try to draw the operation process chart or outline process chart. This is very important, or first chart which we have studied in method study. Now these are some important points which are to be remembered for preparation of operation process chart. This is very important. First is, charting is used for recording because it gives a complete picture of what is being done and helps the mind to understand the tasks and their relationship to one another. Charts are an important means of illustrating clearly to everyone concerned the way the job is being carried out. The details which appears on a chart must be obtained from direct observation. Charting must not be based on memory, but must be prepared as the work is observed. Except when a chart is prepared to illustrate a proposed new method. A high standard of neatness and accuracy should be maintained in preparing fair copies of charts constructed from direct observation to maintain their value for further reference and to provide as a complete information as possible. All charts should carry a heading like a name of the product, materials or equipment charted with drawing number or code numbers. Finally, before leaving the chart, check the following points. Have the facts been correctly recorded? Have all factors contributing to the process been recorded? Now these are some advantages of operation process chart. First, improve shop part layout. Simplified layout we are showing by using operation process chart. So these are the advantages. Helps in specifying the basic manufacturing system. Helps in determining sequence of assembly and the scheduling activities regarding dates of purchased material and completion days for fabricated parts. As we are showing time also on operation process chart, we can easily know what is the total completion time or cycle time we can say for particular job. To introduce the new technical person with manufacturing system. If any new person is coming in new industry, then for him it is easiest way to explain the entire procedure of our industry by using outline process chart.
Now, after doing outline process chart, next chart we are going to study is flow process chart. Outline process chart showing us bird's eye view of overall industry, and no major activities are studied in or shown in outline process chart. But in case of flow process chart, we are going some in details of our operations. We are not looking as a bird in a, to an industry, but we are going to depth of that industry. Depth means it is not also a every each and every activity of industry, but it is more deeper. It is deeper than flow process outline process chart, we can say. A flow process chart summarizes the flow and activity of compensation through a procedure in terms of operation, transportation, inspection, delay and storage. It also includes the information about time required and distance moved. Flow process chart can be defined as a graphical representation of all the operations, inspections, delays and storage occurring during a process or procedure, which includes information considered necessary for analysis like time required, quality and distance moved, etc. It is the amplification of the operation process chart. Last line is very important. First three points are very similar to outline process chart, but last line saying that it is amplification of operation process chart. That means we are going much more detail in the particular operations, but which is not possible in operation or outline process chart. So this is the example of flow process chart. So if we look the flow process chart, the overall appearance of flow process chart is like the big square or rectangle in which all these activities are included. Outline process chart was only the straight lines represented for all the activities, but here we are showing detailed activities. So as usual, before going to activities, we have to write the job name, part number. As we already discussed in case of charts, every chart at the topmost portion there is job description. So in this example, job description is such as machine part with NC drill press. Job number is RH070491. Analyst is R. Hall. Now after that, step number is given. Step numbers are mentioned. After that, second column, detailed steps or name of steps are given here. After these two columns, there are five columns, and each column is dedicated for particular symbol. For example, first is for operation, and we know for operation circular symbol is used. So in first column, only circles are symboled here. In second, it is transportation, and we know for transportation arrow directed towards right is used. So in transportation column, all arrows are shown here. Similarly, for inspection, square boxes are shown here, and for delay, half circle is shown here, and storage, we know inverted triangle is used, and last column is used for representing the time. So we will go one by one. First operation is inspect the coming part. Our operation is starting with inspection. So for inspection, we are using square box symbol. So our line, if we look our line for first operation, our line is starting with square box. It is inspection. And second is prepare part for machining. Preparing means it is an activity or operation. So for operation, we know we are using circular symbol. So from square box, line is approaching towards the circular symbol. Third is also operation, positioning the part. So line will remain straight. After preparation, it will go to the positioning. That means it is also an operation. Again, fourth is also operation. Line will again remain straight. Fifth is also operation, removing the part from machine. It is also operation. So these four, second, third, fourth and fifth, line will remain straight only. Now sixth operation, it is inspection. Inspect the finished job. Now again our line will approach toward the square box. After inspection, there is assembly step. So for seven, it is coming back to the operation stage. It is coming approach, line is approaching to the circle. Then placing on cart, it is also an operation. So it is straight, it will remain straight to the up to the 8. After 8th step, 9th step is fully load cart. Loading means it is not any operation, loading requires some time. So it is shown as a delay. Loading means jobs are waiting for something. So our line will go to the half circle, that means delay. And after that, full cart goes to the final assembly. We are shifting parts to the assembly. So this is a transportation. So our line is going to the arrow mark. Similarly, we can draw the flow process chart. If we take our daily life example, for example, we are making sandwich. So we can divide the making sandwich in all the steps, taking the bread, cutting the breads, then taking the vegetable pieces or taking the cheese, transporting cheese from refrigerator to the kitchen. So all these steps, we can write down all the procedure. Similarly, we can do we can draw the symbol and we can draw these lines also. We can I suggest everyone to draw this flow process chart for our daily life example, so we can easily understand all this example. And time is also, we forget to talk about time. The time is mentioned here. After looking towards the time, we can calculate overall time required for flow process chart. Now, what are the objectives of flow process chart? These are mentioned here. The major objective of drawing the flow process chart is to examine the process in order to make it much more efficient and effective, to study the event in a systematic way, to improve the layout, to improve material handling, to reduce delays, to eliminate, combine or rearrange the events in a systematic way, to compare two or more alternative methods. Now if we look towards this flow process chart, we can suggest a new method where we can save the time, but all this optimization is only possible after studying the flow process chart. So flow process chart is very important.
Next symbol is arrow directed towards right. It is used for transportation. It indicates the movement of worker, material or equipment from one place to another place. For example, movement of materials from one workstation to another. Now, first chart is outline process chart, or it is also called operation process chart. Now, this chart is used to give bird's eye view. Suppose there is one person who is new for any industry and he wants to know what is the overall procedure of any kind of industry. if that particular industry is producing valves or we can say nut and bolts, then what is the sequence of operation and how what are the location of each and every machineries and how the procedure occurs, what will be the flow of material.
This slide is talking about information shown in a flow process chart. So first information is type of the flow process chart. As we discussed, there are three types: material type, man type, and equipment type. Type is first mentioned here. Then information of the person producing the part. Person ka information is also important, which is shown in this flow process chart, which was not there in operation process chart or outline process chart. Information place, time, and name of vendor for whom the product or process is prepared, different stages and their involvement in the process, transportation activity, its various stages and distances traveled, different stages of delay, storage, and inspection, summarized information of activities.
So, importance of operation process chart or outline process chart, we can see it is helpful to visualize the complete sequence of operations and inspection in the process. Know where the operation selected or detailed study fits into entire process. Understand the graphic representation of the points at which materials are introduced into the process and what operations and inspections are carried out on them as shown.
So this is another example of flow process chart. If we look topmost part, they are mentioning the type of flow process chart. It is a material type of flow process chart. So man and equipment words are roughed. So it is material type. Then come to second row of this flow process chart. There is chart number, sheet number. Then summary is also given here. Subject charted, used bus engines. So here subject is given. Then activities are also mentioned here in the fourth row: stripping, cleaning, and degreasing prior to the inspection. Method is also given here. Then in fifth row, they are talking about location, degreasing shop, and in sixth row, operatives. That means name of worker can be mentioned, and charted means an analyst name. And approved means authoritarian person above the analyst in hierarchy, and date should be written here. Come to the right portion of this chart, there is summary ka mentioned. So summary, there are four columns. First is activity, second is present, then proposed, and saving. So five activities are there: operation, transportation, delay, inspection, and storage. For operation, it requires total 4 hours, and four minutes. And for transportation, it requires 21 minutes. For delay, 3 minutes. For inspection, 1 minute, and for storage, 1 minute. If we want to propose any new method to store the to save the transportation time, then we can write here time. And we can write in last column savings of time. And total distance travel is also mentioned here, 237.5. If by applying, we already studied in PPC sequencing and scheduling. So if we are succeeded in saving the distances, then in proposed column we can write new distance, and in savings we can write saved distance. Similarly, cost can also be written here, and total is also written in this upper portion of the chart. And in lower portion, we drawn the actual chart. So first column is description column, second quantity ka column, third is distance ka column, and fourth is time ka column, and fifth is actual chart. Here five symbols are shown. And sixth, we can write a remark. So we will see one by one. first operation first step is stored in a old engine store. This is then storage operation, and we know storage operation is indicated by inverted triangle. So our graph is starting from inverted triangle. If we see the first step, our line here in symbol ka column, our line is starting from inverted triangle. Then second is engine picked up. That means from storage we are going to the transportation activity. Picking up means it is a transportation. So next line is approaching towards the right arrow directed towards right. As we know, arrow directed towards right is used for transportation. Next is transported to the next crane. Again it is transportation, so line will remain straight. Then unload to the floor. This is also one type of transportation, so line will remain straight. Picked up, this is also transportation, line will remain straight. Transported to the stripping bay, line will remain straight. Unloaded to floor, line will remain again straight. Then next operation, engine stripped, that means stripping operation. Now our line will approach towards the circle. Line is inclined and it is approaching the circle. Again, the next is operation, main components cleaned and laid out. It is also operation, line will remain straight here. Then components inspected for wear and inspection report written. This is an inspection step, so line will approach to the inspection, and we know inspection ka symbol is square box, so line is approached square box. And last is parts carried to the degreasing basket. That means it is a transportation operation, so our operation is ending at this arrow mark. Similarly, we can draw all the flow process charts.
So for recording, we are using charts and diagrams. So charts are most extensively used techniques to record the events for method study, and these are used to show sequence movements of man and material. Next symbol is arrow directed towards right. It is used for transportation. It indicates the movement of worker, material or equipment from one place. Now next question may be arise, which information we are going to use in chart. So information required in chart are shown here. First is name of the product, material with code if any. At the topmost part of chart, we are going to specify the name of product and which operation is to be done, and material ka name. All the specifications are mentioned in top position of chart. Then second is process under review with starting and end point. So this is also important point to be noted. Third is chart reference number and number of sheets if any. And fourth is name of work study, analyst and approver of the same. Fifth is date of study, and sixth, summary of distance, time. And now next is for drawing or constructing chart, there we must follow some steps. Steps are given here. It start with drawing an arrow to show the entry of the man materials, writing above the description of the component and below the line the description. And last is equipment type of flow process chart, and it is talking about equipment ka action. A flow process chart which records how equipment was used, it will not indicate any movement of man or materials. Obviously
it is used for equipment only.